Hello everybody, Michael here for Tactica Imperialis. I have another 40k Tactics video today. I'm going to talk about the monstrous creatures, because in 6th edition there have been, not necessarily an influx, but an increase in the number of monstrous creatures. For example, we now have the Tau Riptide, the Eldar Wraith Knight, and the Tyranids have had at least three more added into their codex as well. So I think it would be best for me to talk about them, how to deal with them, and how to deal with their flying versions, as well as to use them, of course, because as much as I don't like monstrous creatures as an Imperial Guard player, I do understand that some people do like using them, because they are damn powerful. So, a monstrous creature follows most rules for infantry, except it gains move through cover, because it just bashes its way through. It has smash, which allows it to halve its attacks to double its strength in melee, making it a very good vehicle killer. I believe its attacks in melee are all AP2. And it has the Relentless rule, meaning it can fire heavy guns on the move. Many monstrous creatures can also be upgraded to be flyers, or flying monstrous creatures. They don't follow quite the same rules for flyers. They have access to Vector Strike, which means that they can fly over the enemy and causing hits on them. The monster's strength. They can also move around a lot more, then go to two different modes, Swoop or Glide. One very much to Zoom, other one quite similar to being Jump Infantry. So, monster creatures in general have a high toughness, a high strength, a high number of wounds, and a high armor save. The typical monstrous creature would be toughness 6, strength 6, 4 to 6 wounds, and a 3 plus armor save in general. Of course, there are exceptions. The Necron Catan has a 4 plus save and is perhaps not as tough. The Eldar Wraith Knight is something stupid. If it's anything like I think it's something like toughness 8, I've heard. I haven't got the Eldar Codex to verify that, I'm afraid. Excuse me. So, generally they are very hard to take down. And so this is something you need to adapt your army for, because anti-tank weapons are just as good at anti-monster. Yes, armor bane weapons such as melter guns don't have armor bane against them because there's no armor technically. But anything that's AP3, AP2, AP1, strength 6, strength 7, strength 8, anything in that range can really do damage to a monstrous creature, particularly on mass. Even strength 5 will generally cause a smattering of wounds. So, yes, your main inline infantry with their strength 3 and 4 guns, wounding on 6s, are not going to be your best bets here. Excuse me, I'm rather ill, but I do think this is something that needs saying, and, well, you guys deserve to know, so that comes first. Anyway, the problem that most people have with monster creatures is not just bringing them down, because generally monster creatures don't have that high an initiative in melee, so they can be mobbed and brought down by a mass of attacks before they get to attack. However, monster creatures don't need to get into melee to wreak the damage. The Eldar Wraith Knight has the massive sun cannon, which is longer than its arm and is deadly. The Riptide can mount a heavy birth cannon or a heavy ion cannon, I believe it's called. Flying Hive Tyrant can mount 2 Twin-Link Devourers of Drain Leech Worms, and so on. They can pack really big guns as well as big melee weapons, meaning they're just as much of a threat back here as they are up there, which is problematic for you. So, of course, and they can't be stunned or shaken like vehicles, so they can be really annoying to put down. Particularly in the case of the Riptide, because it has the ability to Nova Charge, shield generate, and give itself a 3 plus invulnerable save, or it can boost its gun, or it can boost its jetpack. There's a risk, of course, it can hurt the Riptide. I touched on this when I did my gun lines video, but it can make the Riptide either really survivable, really powerful, and so on. However, the Riptide is one of the weaker ones. It's not got 100 million different gimmicks going for it. It's just got the typical battle suit systems. So how would you take a monstrous creature down, generally? I would suggest, as I said, high strength and or low AP. Obviously, higher strength is going to be causing more wounds, but low AP is going to be making those wounds capped. So, strike a balance. Blast weapons, perhaps not so good, because monstrous creatures being a single model, if it scatters, there's a bit more risk of it not doing anything if it scatters a bit. So you have to bear that in mind. Save your blast templates for infantry and such, but of course if you run out of things to target with those blast templates, then sure, drop them on the monstrous creatures. I know I would. Flyers could be quite handy as well, because most monstrous creature guns are basically blast weapons. The heavy venom cannon, the sun cannon, the ion cannon, most of them are anti-infantry, anti-tank weapons, but are blast weapons, so don't have the ability to target flyers. So flyers can be quite good at jinking around and killing the monstrous creatures with whatever they've got, whether it be it Skyhammer missile launched on a Storm Talon, las cannons on a Vendetta, and whatever else. Of course, this brings me quite conveniently onto the other type of monstrous creature, the flying monstrous creature. This trades off some of its power for manoeuvrability. Some say that I would say flying monstrous creatures are better than regular monstrous creatures because they're harder to take down. They are under the same rules as flyers, at least when they're in swoop mode. They have vector strike, and they can still pack some pretty powerful guns. I know it's quite common for Hive Tyrants to pack two Twin Link Devourers with Brain Leech Worms, which are incredibly nasty to infantry. And of course, there is things like the Harpy and the Hive Chrome, just in the Nid army. Obviously, they're not. And then you have the Chaos Demon Prince. Most demons are FMCs instead of being regular ones, or can be upgraded to be anyway. So it's really hard to pin them down. And this is where your flyers again become amplified, because they are the best bet to take them down as you are with regular flyers. Bear in mind though that if you can hit and cause a wound, I don't know if it has to be saved or unsaved, on a flying monster creature, there is a chance that it will crash, take a strength 9 hit, and be grounded next turn, meaning you can fire more at it. So don't, in this case, discount your small arms fire, because obviously you'll probably get a wound or maybe two wounds through, possibly cause an armor save to be failed and bring it down, crash, takes a wound. I had some success with this. I was playing against our Tyranid player. I unmasked his Hive Tyrant with Laz guns, caused a wound, he crashed. I was then able to mob him in melee and bring him down. I admit I got some very lucky dice that day, but the tactic is slightly viable. Obviously, at this point, it negates those blast weapons that I was talking about earlier, so it becomes even more essential that you have a lot of single shots on non-blast guns. So to come back to the Tyranids, because they are the king of the monstrous creature, they can field a monstrous creature in every force organisation slot going. They have the Hive Tyrant, Old One Eye and Co. up in the HQ section. In the Elites, there's the Harris Specs, and there's possibly some others. In the Troops, by taking 30 termagants as a squad, you unlock the Turbigon, which can spawn more Gaunts and suddenly becomes a troop choice to claim an objective. So, and then you go to Fast Attack, you have the Harpy and the Hive Crone, you go to Heavy Support, you have the Tyrann effects, the Exocrine, the Karn effects. There could be others as well. And it can be really pesky for your opponent if you are a team to play who's running this, as I call it, or as it's been called, Nidzilla, which is just masses of monstrous creatures on the board. Yes, it's like my Mech Army video that I put up yesterday, as I record this, so Thursday. It was not the best at board control, but it could wreck anything it hit. Yes, it lacks a bit in anti-infantry in this case, but you can account for this by the upgrades you take and by the stuff you take alongside it, of course. So, as a monstrous creature player, some of the things you need to be wary of. One, you are not going to get cover saves very much. Monstrous creatures are so big that regular infantry don't offer them cover save. And with the advent of the Tau Markolite, this can be even more amplified, meaning it can strip away any cover save you may happen to have and bring you crashing down or just wounded. Oh, sorry. Also bear in mind that you've not got that many attacks. Most monstrous creatures top out at about 4 attacks in melee. Some have more, I think the Trigon may have more, but generally they don't have that many attacks. So you have to play to the strengths of the monstrous creature. That is its survivability and its hitting power, its brute power. So obviously you need to kill any tanks or anti-tank guns that can be turned on your monstrous creatures. Using flying ones or using your other units to do this instead of having to charge up the field to melee, because that can get quite difficult. Make sure you bring enough anti-infantry firepower. So for example, as a Tau player, you may want to bring a heavy burst cannon because that can just unleash a swathe of shots. A Tyrann effects may want to bring a flesh borer hive because that's 20 shots and can whittle down infantry very effectively. So don't neglect anti-infantry, because there is a good chance that enough infantry can bog you down and just slow you up, stop you getting to where you need to be. You also have to be aware with enemy reserves coming in the backfield, claiming line breaker, taking cheap shots. You may have to turn around and deal with this. which means that you've got less going forward. I would not advocate a mass monster list because it is very unbalanced. Of course, if your opponent's not ready for it, then they will get crushed, probably. But it's very likely that a Nid or mass monster list can get beaten quite easily by being run around the board, not getting enough objectives, getting Linebreaker against, and just being unable to do its job properly. Of course, in a kill point mission, this is not so bad because you've not got a lot of kill points on the table. But I would advocate bringing a balancer, so maybe bring one or two monstrous creatures, possibly three if you've got the space, but filling the rest out with infantry, vehicles if applicable, elite infantry, solid HQ, whatever else you generally run, and supplement it with your monsters. Use them as bullet magnets to take the shots away from your key units, or to run up the board and cause carnage on their own, or to be a deterrent, whatever you want to use them for. So, to recap, because I'm having to do this now, with monster creatures, in terms of using them, shield them if you can. Obviously, beware you won't always get cover saves. Make sure you support them with other units like infantry, vehicles, and other things that can help them do their job. And then run them in one of two ways, either as a wrecking ball of destruction or as a bullet shield, whichever works for you. In terms of going against them, go with anti-tank guns, aim at the monsters. Make sure you have at least one flyer to combat FMCs and or regular monstrous creatures who can't hit it back. If you're running against a flying monstrous creature, be aware that you can ground it, so don't be afraid to turn a lot of firepower at it, even if you don't get a lot of hits and wounds. That's about it, really. So, thank you for watching the video. Sorry if I sound a little bit ill. That's something I'm hoping to crack by the end of the week. This video should be up on Sunday. Leave your opinions in the comment section. Like the video if you enjoyed it. Is there any other tactics you want me to cover? I know I want to cover psychers as soon as I can get a copy of the rulebook to look at the psychic disciplines and general other things. So that's all for today. Thank you again for watching. My name is Michael and I will see you again.